Hey guys, this is Eddie aka Bulletproof Monk. Welcome to my video on how to fix your Galaxy Ace. So I've had my Samsung Galaxy Ace for a while, and I've discovered that after I use the phone for a while, it just keeps running out of internal memory. And I've done a lot of research on how to fix the problem. It seems like the only solution is install another mod and then install Link2SD, which requires partitioning of your SD card. And there's a lot of different tutorials on how to do it, and I don't think I've found one single tutorial that explains the whole thing. Especially for the Samsung Galaxy Ace. So I've just decided to put together my own tutorial on how to do everything, just in case you're like me, stuck with a Samsung Galaxy Ace and can't do anything with it because it keeps running out of space. Before we do proceed with the tutorial, you need to understand that I take no responsibility for any damage that this could do to your phone if you do follow through with the tutorial and what happens to your warranty. It's very possible that your phone will no longer have a valid warranty if you proceed. So on the screen you can see some steps on how I have managed to do this. And some of them come from different websites, tutorials. All of their addresses are shown on the screen. Number one, backup your phone. And this process, again, it's your responsibility. I take no responsibility if you lose any of your data through rooting or modding your phone. The safest way for me to back up all my data is, number one, I made sure all of my phone contacts are on Gmail. The good thing about that is by typing all my phone contacts on Gmail, that means if I ever lose any contacts or if I ever swap phones, it's always on Gmail. And if I want to import Gmail contacts to my phone, with most Android phones, it's just a matter of installing your Google account on your phone and all the contacts are imported automatically. So, and you can also make your phone save new contacts on Gmail automatically. So all of my contacts are on Gmail, and that way I never lose any contacts. Your calendar, make sure it's in sync with Google Calendar, so nothing from your calendar will be lost. Make sure all of your SD card contents, photos, videos, music are copied to your computer. And again, you're in charge of backing up your phone and restoring your backup if anything goes wrong. Okay, so basically I take no responsibility for anything that could happen while you are doing this tutorial. You are following this at your own risk. In step 2, you're going to flash the official stock firmware on Samsung Galaxy Ace using Odin. Now you need to download Odin, which is a program used to flash the official stock firmware onto your phone. And then you obviously need to download the official stock firmware and also some other files you need in the flashing process. All the files that you need are on this website here, so click that website. I will make a link to it on the bottom of this video, so you can click on that link, download all the files that you need, and then come back to the video. So the Odin multi-downloader looks like this. Right, if you follow this website here, you should be able to download this program. And there's three steps that you need to do to set up this program to flash the official stock firmware onto your phone. Number one, select OPS. You're going to click that and you're going to select Copa version 1.0.ops, which is a file that you also downloaded from this website on the left in step two. So you're going to select that file. You're going to tick these three boxes in this row here: one, package, auto reboot, protect OPS. And down the bottom where it says one package, you're going to click that and you're going to select the official stock ROM that you downloaded, official stock firmware that you downloaded. And that's also from this website here. Make sure you go there and download the official stock firmware for your phone, and my one is here. You might need to unzip the file, extract the MD5 file from the archive that you download for your official stock firmware. It should just be one single .md5 file, so extract that out and click that in your Odin multi-downloader. And notice how it says check MD5 OK, so it's passed the check. That means this file is valid for you to flash onto your phone. Now, what do you do with your phone? So right now your phone should be powered off completely, and only when it is totally powered off, that's when you turn it on into download mode. And what you're going to do is hold the volume down button, which is here, so hold that down and hold down the home button, which is this one here with your thumb, and then power it on with the power button. So hold down these two buttons, press the power button, and don't let go. And now you can see that it says downloading. So when it says downloading, that means it's in download mode. And that's when you connect your phone with the USB cable to your computer. So connect that, connect it up. And now let's go back to the computer and see what it says. Okay, so now that you've connected your USB cord to your phone, you'll notice that Odin downloader now has a yellow color appearing there. And what that means is you can now safely click the start button to download the stock firmware onto your phone. So if you click the start button, notice, I'll say this again, you're doing this at your own risk. So click the start button and now it's starting to download the mod onto your phone. Now this is going to take a while, probably 5 to 6 minutes. So I'm just going to let it run. Okay, so it's been about 5 minutes, and you'll notice that on the Odin multi-downloader, it now says pass. And down the bottom here, it says kill timer. That means number two is now successful. Now, it doesn't actually matter what your phone is doing, because we're not going to use the official stock firmware anyway. We're going to go on to step three, which is install the latest Clockwork mod recovery. So you're going to click on this link here, which is going to give you a tutorial on how to install Clockwork mod. And that is actually the important part to modding your phone. So click on that. Okay, so for step three, what you're going to do is click on the older multi-downloader again to open that up. And this time, you're going to select Cooper, OPS again, and then select one package. And down the bottom right-hand side, you're going to select the Clockwork mod recovery that you have just downloaded from this webpage here. So double click on that. And then your phone, you're going to do exactly the same thing as we did before. You're going to turn it off. And you're going to put it into download mode. So right now your phone should be powered off completely, and only when it is totally powered off, that's when you turn it on into download mode. And what you're going to do is hold the volume down button, which is here, so hold that down, and hold down the home button, which is this one here with your thumb, and then power it on with the power button. So hold down these two buttons, press the power button, and don't let go. And now you can see that it says downloading. So when it says downloading, that means it's in download mode. And that's when you connect your phone with the USB cable to your computer. So connect that, connect it up. And now let's go back to the computer and see what it says.